Several years ago, me and my family went to visit the native place of my wife, somewhere deep in Andhra, which is actually popular for hot chilies. And we were accompanied by the relatives of my wife as well. It was a family tour, so to say. We went by the car and we were returning back. As we were returning, we saw there were some forms full of hot chili peppers, hot chilies, so red, and it was right at the peak of the bloom, and the forms were absolutely picturesque. So the relatives of my family stopped their cars and started taking, you know, selfie pictures of themselves with the plants, posing with the chilies. And we also stopped. We went closer to the chilies. My elder son Srimukh and I couldn't stop the temptation to pluck a chili each and start biting into it just to see how hot it is. Is it really good enough or not? And we would bite away a small piece each and started chewing all of the chili little by little. So the relatives of my wife were completely stunned. They said, "What is this? We are only taking pictures of the red chilies, and here are two guys who are actually eating them and enjoying it." And what is even worse is, or astonishing is, my son, who was only around 13 or 14 years, I think, they were surprised that, you know, such a small boy is eating chilies, while these relatives, who actually come from that part of the country, and have eaten chilies all their childhood, it's included in their spicy food, they don't eat them raw. But here is this young guy, 13, 14 year old boy, who is eating chilies raw and enjoying it. Oh, by the way, for those of you who are new to this channel, in this series, I am making kind of a course on raw food diet fundamentals. This will consist of three segments. One is talking about the philosophy of raw food. The second will talk about the general guidelines to making recipes in raw food. And the third is talking about specific ingredients, why we use them in the raw food, from a functionality point of view, from a nutrient point of view, from a taste point of view. We would cover today's video on whether spicy food is good for you. We will have to look at this in two parts. One is whether it is good for you clinically speaking. We don't know what it will be like, right? So we will listen to that. The second is, if you happen to like spicy food, then what should you do about it? Clinically speaking, it was found that chilies have a chemical called capsaicin. This capsaicin gives it the uniqueness to chili peppers, the green chilies. They activate the pain sensors in our tongue and give it a signal that this is something hot. You know, the hotness that we find in chilies is because of this capsaicin telling the brain through the sensors that we are eating something hot by temperature. There's no such thing as a taste called hot. Hot is just a temperature. Brain thinks that you are eating something hot by temperature, and it immediately salivates a little more to cool it down.
and once it cools down, during that process, a chemical called as dopamine is released, and one other chemical I don't remember now, they are released, and they give you a feeling of happiness, a relief, an enjoyment. That's what makes raw chilies as hot. We define 6 different tastes in available in universe. I have covered that in a previous video, and hotness is not one of them. This is just a sensation that we get when you bite into an item such as this, which hits those pain sensors on the tongue. So several studies have been done, and particularly 2 large studies in the UK and the US. The US one went up to 17,000 participants, and they have confirmed in all of these studies that capsaicin helps the health in a big way. It helps avoiding cancer or curing cancer, particularly avoiding cancer. It helps in control of insulin so that the type 2 diabetes can be in control. It helps in digestion. When you eat spicy food, you eat less. That means you are eating less energy food, less caloric food, and therefore it aids in weight loss. It also helps the skin in several ways and make it glow and keep it smooth. So these are some of the main benefits that come from capsaicin. So good health benefits have actually been established through these clinical studies. Now that having said, there is also a concern that these studies have indicated what people who eat spicy food, particularly the Asians, what kind of food they eat, which is giving these clinical benefits. And I forgot to mention, the life expectancy of people who eat spicy food, I believe, is substantially high. So the concern is that maybe it is those other ingredients which go with spicy food which is giving these health benefits, and not necessarily capsaicin. Although they have tried directly giving just the capsaicin and chili food to mice and found that it works. The way I look at it is, whether it is capsaicin or anything that I typically add with spicy food, if it is giving me health benefits, then so be it. It is good for me, right? I don't care if I am adding a little bit of lemon along with this, if I add a little bit of salt along with it, or if the kind of other foods that I add do not include bananas, for example, or sweet food. Yeah, whatever works, you know, it does help in giving health benefits. The next question that comes up is, what should you do if you like spicy food? A bigger question that comes up, in fact, what exactly is spicy food? Spicy food is not necessarily those hot items such as chilies.
Spices include your cinnamon, cardamom, cloves, and so on and so forth. So if spicy food is something that you like, let your taste buds decide whether you wanted to eat it or not. As you may have noticed, in my case, I like spicy food. One other story I would like to share on this is that my younger brother had done a visit to southern India and brought some chilies from a farm. Apparently, these were the second hottest chilies in the world after something that is grown in South America. So I took one of them, and yes, it was extremely hot compared to anything that I have tried so far. And I wanted to try one more time. and more. So I started chewing bit by bit and finished the whole chili. It was a small chili. They are very hot, but they are very small. Finished it and then reached out for a second one. And my mom was scolding me, "Why are you eating so much of chilies? It may not be good for you." So what I'm trying to say is, you know, your taste buds should decide what you like. On this planet, all the species eat what they like, when they salivate, when then an emotion triggers that you want to eat, when you look at something raw. The important thing is though raw. If you want to cook and mix and chemically modify several things and then decide whether you want to eat or not, then you are misleading what the brain is telling you, what your emotion is telling you, what your tongue is telling you. If on the other hand, as raw, if you find something that you want to eat, then probably it is good for you. If you look at an apple or an orange, and this orange makes you feel like you want to eat it, go ahead and then eat it. If you look at a coconut and feel like eating it, go ahead and then eat it. And if you are like me, you look at a green chili or you look at a green lime, lemon, yellow lemon, whatever. If you want to eat it just like that raw, go ahead and eat it. It is good for you. So let your taste buds decide what is good for you and then eat it. It may so happen that when you urinate, it burns, or when you do the nature call the next day, it burns. And if this is something that happens to you, that means you are not used to so much of spiciness in the food. If you are eating regularly spicy food, these feelings will go away, the sensations will go away. Does it mean I am encouraging you to eat more and more spicy food? I'm not pushing you to eating more and more spicy food. If you don't like it, you don't have to. All I'm trying to say is, if you like spicy food, go ahead and then eat it. It is good for you. Clinically, it is proven that it helps in reducing the cancer, the diabetes, the weight loss, the skin benefits, longevity of life, and so on. So if there are so many benefits, why stop it? Just go ahead and then eat it. Let your taste buds decide. I hope this video has made some sense to you. Some information might have been given to you. In addition to my own experience, I looked at some amount of data which is available over the internet and came to these conclusions which I presented in the video today. If it has given some information to you and you think this was useful, please click on that like button. Subscribe to my channel and click on the notification bell if you would like to see these kind of videos that will help you make healthier. Thank you for your time and have a nice day or evening, whatever is left for you. Bye bye.